symbolic and intimate knowledge. We have two kinds of knowledge, which I call symbolic knowledge and intimate knowledge. I do not know whether it would be correct to say that reasoning is only applicable to symbolic knowledge, but the more customary forms of reasoning have been developed for symbolic knowledge only. The intimate knowledge will not submit to qualification and analysis, or rather, when we attempt to analyze it, the intimacy is lost and it is replaced by symbolism. For an illustration, let us consider humor. I suppose that humor can be analyzed to some extent, and the essential ingredients of different kinds of wit classified. Suppose that we are offered an alleged joke. We are subjected to scientific analysis as we would a chemical salt of a doubtful nature, and perhaps after careful consideration of all its aspects, we are able to confirm that it is really and truly a joke. Logically, I suppose, our next procedure would be to laugh, but it may certainly be predicted that as a result of the scrutiny, we have lost all inclination we may have ever had to laugh at it. It does simply not expose the inner workings of a joke. The classification concerns a symbolic knowledge of humor, which preserves all the characteristics of a joke except its laughableness. The real appreciation must come spontaneously, not introspectively. I think this is not an unfair analogy of our mystical feeling for nature, and I would venture even to apply it to our mystical experience of God. There are some to whom the sense of divine presence irradiating the soul is one of the most obvious things of experience. In their view, a man without this sense is to be regarded as we regard a man without a sense of humor. The absence is a kind of mental deficiency. We may try to analyze the experience as we analyze humor and construct a theology, or it may be an atheistic philosophy. We shall put it into scientific form, what is to be inferred about it. But let us not forget that this theology is symbolic knowledge, whereas the experience is an intimate knowledge. And as laughter cannot be compelled by a scientific exposition of structure of a joke, so a philosophic discussion of the attributes of God, or an impersonal substitute, is likely to miss the intimate response, the spirit, which is central point of the religious experience.